Welcome back, everyone. Have you guys upgraded your iPhone to iOS 16? The new wallpaper is awesome. But after upgrading to iOS 16, I'm sure you must meet the situation that your iPhone stuck on Apple logo for no reason. No matter how you try, it just keeps going back to the Apple logo. Don't worry, I will show you 3 ways to fix this problem, only for the iOS software issue. First method, force restart iPhone 8. You should try this when there are bugs occur on your iPhone. Press volume up and quickly press volume down, then press and hold the power button. Wait until the Apple logo appears, then you have completed the force restart. Normally, your iPhone should be okay again. If it goes back to the Apple logo screen, then you can follow next method. Second method, repair iPhone 8 stuck on Apple logo with Tenorshare ReiBoot. This is an iOS system repair tool. It can fix more than 150 iOS system issue. Include iPhone stuck on Apple logo. Check the download link in the description if you are interested. Once installed, connect your iPhone 8 to PC or Mac and open ReiBoot. If ReiBoot didn't detect your iPhone 8, you need to put it in recovery mode first. Click the green start button. Choose standard repair. You will require to download firmware to repair your iPhone 8. Click it. The download process will not be long, depending on your network condition. Once the download is finished, click the Start Standard Repair option. ReiBoot will start to repair your iPhone 8. This process will take some time. Be patient. Do not disconnect your iPhone during the process. Then it is done. You can see my iPhone 8 is back to its normal state. Go give it a try. Third method, fix iPhone 8 stuck on Apple logo with iTunes. To fix iPhone 8 with iTunes, you need to put your iPhone 8 in recovery mode first. So connect your iPhone to iTunes. It's the same operation as force restart, but this time keep holding till the recovery mode screen shows up. Then you should see iTunes pop up a window. Here we choose update. Agree on those terms, then iTunes will begin to download the firmware that is needed. Once the download is completed, it will start to update your iPhone. This process will take a long time, so I will skip them. Then you can see my iPhone 8 is back to normal state again. If iTunes is not a comfortable choice for you or taking you too much time, you can follow the second method. That's it. Hope this video is helpful to you. I will be grateful if you subscribe. See you guys next time.